and Chinese men that were tied to walls would show worm movies out of their penises into the air in apparent disgruntle and dismay. And it would be wadded up like a little girl would like wad up some tissue after she's blown her nose and look in it in the horror, seeing little speckled pieces of blood in her snot that was on that rag that she had wadded up. And then she threw it away, knowing that that was her life in there, and that her life would never be the same, because the world was divided up into four parts. There was the Magus, the Tutor, the Fancor, and the Daria. And the Daria and the Fancor were at war with the Tutor and the Fartalus, who I haven't mentioned to this point, because they were the fifth part, who were invisible, and they were all powerful. And they were beyond the worms and beyond the Chinese men tied to the wall, who would show worm movies out of their penises, and who had originally been non-existent at all, and they never knew how to make fireworks, or ever rifles, or even, they never knew anybody from Saskatchewan, and they didn't know how to dial on the telephone. And they had these Volkswagen buses that they had designed like they were cathedrals of God. And they had directed all of us, all of my relatives, the worms, and the Chinese man himself. They had traveled hundreds and thousands of miles. They had, when they came to the sea, they went under the sea and they talked to the fish. And see, when the fish travel in a line, there will be a little dot near their ear, rear end, and a string will come out. And I have made a kite before, and I have flown it out of the string that I got from the dots on fish's bottom ends. And I've flown it so high that I have been able to see the Etruscans, the Bolivians, the Artesians, and the wall harpers.
What a day.
out at me.
What does it mean? Or
she got these sores on her leg.
Oh. A funeral of sores. On her leg, on her chest, on her arm, on her tongue, on her ear, on her pancreas, on her liver, on her lung, on her other lung, on her heart, and inside her heart, and around her heart, and it traveled out her veins, and it came out, and it went near her paw, and it came out again, and it came near her ear again, and then it shot off onto Trevor's eyelid.
I told him ectoplasm.
It's the thing today.
It's true. I have the true story. Come to me when you want it, Abe.
Why, I oughta.
Oh, God. Great.
Do we eat a lot?
Do you eat a lot?
That is a good question.
Hell yes, we eat a lot. We eat a lot of everything. We eat food.
Thank you.
I was walking with my dad near the State Fair of Texas, and he was walking about 40 feet in front of me. These guys in a pickup truck pulled up next to me and asked me if I wanted a mud jack.
Become
sort of twisted into something that doesn't look like anything you've ever seen before.
And I find that they are developing into a lot of things that have somehow become a part of other things that have developed into four or five or six different modes that I can think of, that they're like ABCs on like a top line, and with pieces of all the different doo-doos that I've taken on the bottom line, and then all the vomits that I've had on the third line, and then all the different french fries on the fourth line, and then a picture of my first girlfriend repeated on the fifth line, all down there, and that you could like take the Roman numerals 1 through 15 down on the column on the left, and on the right you could have look like triangles and circles and triangles and circles on the top there, and if you ever wanted to like cross-section a Roman numeral and either a circle or a triangle, you would have a range of things to pick from, and you could decide how you wanted to act based on that.
Thank you. talking about it last night. There was a flesh deal that come out of my stomach at me. It was a flesh thing, and it come out, and it was long, and it started to sweat, and there was some hair on it, and there was some hair, and a tooth came out of it. God damn, I think there's a fucking dead horse head at the end of this bed, just like in that fucking movie. Fucking shit, it's in there. Fuck!
Oh, that's gross.
Fuck! Oh my God, my racing horse. Oh, fuck! Every morning, it's like
if
an arm or a leg I find somewhere, torn up, shredded, every fucking morning. In the night, I'll find like an eyeball on my toothbrush.
What are you buying?
And like, I'll go pick my teeth and like a vein will come out. And a vein will come out and it'll like travel up my lip. And I'll pull out my nose, out my right nostril, then I can breathe a lot better through my right nostril.
God so loved this world, he gave his only begotten son. And he, whosoever believeth in him, shall not perish. Yeah. Oh, shut up. Thank you, that's all.
Take me to that big old town where I can score some of that. I'm gonna destroy expensive equipment.
Eric. Where? He wasn't specific. He didn't pay much attention.
You tell me.
When I was 13, my father told me what 69ing meant. And then I had to go explain to Annette Swartz, who is 7 years older, that 69ing meant for a man to kiss a woman's vagina while she kissed his penis, whereas she thought it meant 6 inches up and 9 months to wait.
Not again.
How did she ever arrive?
Seems pretty obvious to me.
Did she go to school with you?
No, she was ahead of me.
In what way?
In many ways. She had a friend, and her would wear white straight-legged pants, and they would refuse to bend their knees, or else it would put dimples in the knees.
Okay, now, how many people are Capricorn? All right, we have a Capricorn. Oh. Fuck you, man. He said faking it. Yeah, you walk away. You're a dickhead. What do you got next?
Thank you. give you $200. I'll forget everything.
We want this gift, you know.
$200.
$200.
Yeah. I'll forget everything.
I think it's all I got. No. Well, if you will. I mean, I'll
give. You'll give me $200, and I'll forget everything.
I'd say that 90% of the population would wipe with a $1 bill if given the opportunity.
I'm gonna pull out the mold now. Check it out. There it is. It's kicking ass. Sort of brown. It's got two hairs today. Sometimes I trim them. Sometimes people throw money at me. Yeah, boo! I know this is a fiasco, but hold it. Is it okay if we could play one more song without you pulling my pants down?
No.
And, you know, it's cool to think that we're like inept asshole motherfuckers, but it all has to do a lot with the people that are like hitting us in the head and kicking us in the balls and things like that. And it's like, A lot. Before you say all that, it's like a lot of you people might think that, well, there's a guy that's sitting in front of my door. He doesn't have any arms. He doesn't have any legs. And his name is Matt. Yeah. And you might think that's what is true. But there's this girl with another thing, and we just want to play one more song. So don't try to grab my pants off. Because the people in the hats over there want to arrest me, and don't even look upon there, because they're not even there, because I'm just saying that. I just want to, one more. It's all right, okay? Fuck.
Chicago, my kind of town.
It's the wildest thing.
What about the masonry in Chicago, Greg?
Well, the masonry in Chicago, I think of it, and I have to bring back the old question, how many words have the third letter to be K?
Oak.
Oak? It's, yeah, oak.
Fake?
A canker.
Fake.
A canker. Or
high. Fake. Ink. Ink. Yes, yes, we've had this discussion countless times. We all know them. And yet the masonry in Chicago brings it to mind. Oh, no, I'm sorry.
You've probably been asked it a lot of times. But, right.
Yes and no. Yes, and in as much that, as I have.
But no, in that.
I haven't.
I guess that's, I have one cigarette left, by the way.
Could I borrow your lighter, my friend?
You don't want the cigarette?
No, I have a Marlboro.
They're inferior.
They are inferior. I would prefer a Rothmans, if you dare.
I offered you.
I shall take you up on that offer. I was confused at first, thinking that I'd seen a car wreck, perhaps a cyclone lowering itself from the ceiling and whisping away three or four older women, like, and then their bloody heads had been, one of them got on that diner poster, and then the De Niro thing, it, like, what this deal had come out of here was this tongue at De Niro's mouth over here, and it had shot over Woody Allen, and see, they would look like they were making out on posters across the room.
Not again.
No. And that was like in the last 12 hours.
No, it's just like a quarter of a second ago.
You know, a lot of things that can be said about time can be said about motion.
A lot of things can be said about anything can be said about anything else.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Can I have my lighter back? Thanks.
What's that farting noise I hear?
Farting noise?
Yeah.
You actually didn't hear it until I, like, when you said it. It's deja vu.
When a tree falls
like
in the woods.
Does anyone have a second?
I've already tried.
Mark Farmer, Don Brewer, Mel Shocker, Grand Funk Railroad.
L-S-D-B. L-P-S-D. Smashed his head against the wall. Smashed his head against the wall. Smashed his head against the wall. Smashed his head against the wall.
L-S-D.
Of any man in his class.
Smashed his head against the wall.
Everyone knew what was happening to Tommy.
L-S-D.
Good looking.
Personable.
Monsters.
Blow the man down. Plenty of money and plenty of food. Why the hell blow the man down? Plenty of money and plenty of food. Blow the man down. Plenty of money and plenty of food. I said blow the man down. Why the fuck?
Oh, wow, that was a moment.
Hi. So you guys are from Texas?
Canada.
Thank you.
entire day I'd get just ravishing diarrhea blows after eating the chicken fried steak. And I was usually able to put them off, but one particular day I asked to be excused from the class. And I went down to the bathroom, then I went to the bathroom and I saw all the open stalls, like a row of 20 open stalls, and I just couldn't do it. So I like washed my hands and went back to the room, and Mrs. Vaughn met me out in the hall, and she approached me and said, "Gibby, did you grunt?"
Okay. Thank you. Y'all guys are too nice to us tonight. I gotta hand it, Cole. Could I trade a drumstick for the microphone? Come on, dude. All right. Say whatever you want. Sound men, something we have been lacking this whole set. See this Sennheiser microphone? It's a high quality microphone. But there has been a lack of quasi-ability, if you know what I mean. It's like, what do you call a guy with no arms and legs in front of your door? Matt. It's like, you've heard it all. Okay. Check. All right. Okay. Now, what do you call a hitchhiker? Fuck off. Okay. You wanted me to take off my pants. Now, where is the mic stand? Do I have a political t-shirt on? Does anybody want it?